today's session we will go with the JavaScript methods. Okay, so here we can see the check out the following reference for the documentation for the client side event and object model that can use it for the JavaScript libraries. Okay, so wherever I mentioned there is a stock. Okay, so it is a new methods in a CRM 2013. Okay, so remaining all it is available in a previous version, and wherever this we can see some star symbol, it is a new methods in a JavaScript 2015. Okay, so here the first thing. Okay, so the XRM. Okay, so earlier the first in CRM 4.0 we have a statement like a CRM form. Okay, so here the CRM form, it will gives the all the controls on the CRM form. Okay, so this is a base statement. So when so from 2011 onwards it is a XRM. Okay, so in the XRM you will get the all the controls on the form. Okay, so here in XRM also we will have a some page. Okay, and we have a, in XRM we have a some XRM dot utilities. Okay, utility. So the base is the XRM. This CRM form, it is a 4.0 version. So from 2011 onwards it is a so 4.0 version, CRM 4.0. so from 2011 onwards it is a XRM. Okay, so under the XRM we have a two elements. Okay, so XRM is a base component, or I can say the parent method. Under the XRM we will have a XRM dot page and XRM dot utility, two things we have. Okay, so the first one we will cover the XRM dot utility. What is the use of the XRM dot utility? Okay, so here XRM dot utility object provides the container for the useful method, useful functions not directly related to the current page. The following table list of the functions, it is available in a XRM dot utility. Okay, so the first method in a XRM dot utility. Okay, so alert dialog, you will get the alert dialog. Okay, for example, if it is a XRM dot utility dot alert dialog, so just you are giving a alert dialog box. Okay, so in a regular JavaScript method it is similar to the alert method. Okay, so next one, this is a alert dialog method. So we can write a statement like a XRM dot utility dot alert dialog. Okay, here we have to pass the whatever the message you want to give a alert. Okay, so next one, confirmation dialog. Okay, so the most of the cases we will use the confirmation dialogs. Okay, so it will give you the window, yes sir. Okay, so okay, cancel, two buttons it will give the. So are you sure you want to continue? If you click on okay, it will go for the next level state, it will execute the next level conditions. Okay, so if it is a cancel, just you are stopping the your process in a here. Okay, so just I will write one simple statement. So how we can use these statements, we can see it. Okay, so for writing the JavaScript coding, okay, so we better to use the some tools. Okay, so first we have to define a method, okay, function. Okay, so next I'm just giving alert. The method name I'm giving alert. Okay, so here we can write the alert dialog. Here it is a case sensitive. Okay, so we have to follow the same thing in a MS CRM. Okay, here whatever the message you want to show, okay, just enter, give that message. So here, so giving alert on form load. Okay, so this is a alert. Okay, so I'm just giving a alert. Okay, so this statement I have to use it. Okay, just copy this method. Okay, so here so first we need to we have already created this one JavaScript library. So in that library just I'm calling this method. Okay, so the statement, the must and should end with this semicolon. Okay, so this method I'm attaching to a event. Okay, so we have already set value the event. So just I'm disabling that event. I'm adding a new event. Just giving. Click on OK. Save and publish. Okay. So if we refresh the So go to the account entity. So if you open a new form, so our JavaScript method, it will execute and it will give the pop-up window alert message. So there is a script error. Okay, so there is a script error. It is undefined, giving the referencer is undefined. Okay, okay, save and publish. Okay, so now it is giving a the alert, it is showing the some alert message. So that is a use of the XRM dot, okay, so that is a use of the XRM dot page dot utility dot alert dialog. So by using this method we can able to give the some alert messages to the users, okay. So the next method is a confirm dialog, okay. So it will display the confirmation dialog box and it will contains the message as well, okay, and okay cancel buttons, okay. So the syntax is xrm dot utility dot confirm dialog, okay. So here we have to show message, and if it is, you clicked on okay, what is the method it has to be called. If you click on a cancel, what operation it has to be executed, okay. So this one how we can use the this statement, okay. So we can see the some example. So in the same statement, just I'm commenting this one, okay. So next I'm writing this statement. So here the message, okay. So just I'm giving, are you sure to continue? Are you sure to continue? Okay, if it is here, we have to define a methods. Okay, so for example, so we have a define a success, like a success method. Okay, function. Okay, so success. Or if it is a okay, so just I'm giving a alert, okay. So the same statement I'm using our CRM statement. So just I'm giving your click OK button. So similar we can give the for cancel also. Okay, so these methods we have to call to here. These methods we have to call to here, and these methods we have to call to here. So here what we are saying, we are giving a pop-up window, confirmation dialog window. Are you sure to continue? So it will give the OK and cancel buttons. So if you click on OK, so this OK method it will execute, okay. If you click on a cancel, so this cancel method it will execute, okay. So the same code I am placing there, सकते हैं सेव एंड पब्लिश। ओके सो कंट्रोल F5। So this is a confirmation dialog. The confirmation dialogs it will come like this. Okay. So this is a message I have given there in the syntax. Okay. Are you sure to continue? So if I click on OK, so my OK function is executed. So that is the reason you are seeing this alert message. So if I refresh again. Okay. So if I click on cancel, so this is my cancel method is executed. Okay. So this confirmation dialogs will use the for wherever the some business impacted and we need some confirmation from the client. Okay, so we have to be double sure what they are performing. At the time you will give a confirmation dialogs to the user, so they will proceed to the next level business. Okay. So next this thing is activity type. So it will determine the if an entity is an activity entity or not. Okay, XRM dot utility dot is activity type. If you pass the entity name, it will give the boolean flag. It will return the boolean flag. Okay, so if the you order the input, you put the entity name, is it really it is a activity type? So you will get the value yes. Okay, so if else you will get the false value. Okay, so next method is a open entity form. From a JavaScript you want to open the another entity record. Okay, so that one we have a this statement like a XRM dot utility dot open entity form. Here name is the we have parameter, we have to pass the entity name. And here ID is the we have to pass the GUID of the record. Okay. Okay. And parameters if you want you can pass it. Okay. So this is a statement open entity form. For example, how we can write the code. Okay. So here just I'm commenting this one. Okay. So the first statement is activity type. So here this one. So here I am passing the entity is the account. Okay. So here just I am giving alert. Okay, so just I'm giving alert. It is giving a true or false. Okay, so this is a first example for the XRM dot utility. So next one is the open entity form. So here just we can copy this one. Okay, here we can give it the xlm.txt entity form. So which entity record you want to open? Okay, so just I'm opening the some contact entity, contact record. Okay, contact record, and we need to pass the contact GUID. Okay, so for getting the GUID, okay, so if you go to the contacts, so open any record. In the left hand side, we can see the pop-up window. So it will give the full URL. In that URL, we can find it the ID. Okay. So here we can see the ID. This is the ID. So you have to copy from the. So 7B is a some unique ASCII value, ampersand value, this one. Okay. So here from here to, so again to the percentile value, it is a GUID of the record. Okay. So this parameters is not a mandatory. If you want, you can pass it, or you can simply pass it null. Okay. So this is the statement. So I'm just copying. Okay. So from here to, click on OK. Save and publish. Okay, so again if you go to the accounts, okay, view form, so in onload, so sometimes our latest JavaScript method is, it is not executed. Okay, so at the time we have to press the control F5. So that means control F5, it will clears the cache and it will load the latest JavaScript file from the server. Okay, so now the first statement, whatever we return. Okay, the first statement, this is a alert xrm.utility. Is activity type. So I have passed the entity name account. So account is not a activity type entity. So if I pass the here email or phone call or any other activity type entity, so I will get the result. Okay. So true. Here I am getting a value is a false. Okay. So this one is activity type statement you will use for the most of the times for the checking the this entity is a checking the conditions this entity is a activity type entity or a transactional entity. Okay, so if I click on OK, the next statement it will start execute. So what is the next statement? So xrm.utility.open form. So this statement it will opens the this particular contact, okay. So if I click on OK, so now it is redirected to contact entity, and this is a record, it is got opened. Okay, so this open a entity form, we will use for this. Sometimes we have to open some particular records or particular things from a JavaScript automatically. Okay, so at the time you will use this method. So next one, open web resource. Okay, so next one is the open web resource. So this open web resource, it is similar to the this one. So opening a, it's similar to the opening a form. Okay, and the input parameters we can see web resource name. Okay, we can pass the web resource name, and sometimes we can pass here web resource data. So content also we can able to pass it as a second parameter, and the third parameter is the width, and the fourth parameter is the height. Okay, for example, okay, so I want to open some particular web resource. Okay, on a form. So here just the I'm commenting these two statements. Okay, so here xrm.utility.openwebresource, here we need to pass the web resource name. Okay, so this web resource name is a schema name. So here web resources, if you go to the here in the solution, you are able to see web resources. Okay, so from here I want to open this some web resources. Okay, so from here just this is test HTML. So I want to open this one. So here it is a new underscore HTML. Okay, so here I can pass the name new underscore HTML. So it is just case sensitive. So it is a new underscore HTML. So this is a web resource data. So if you want, you can pass it, or you can simply pass as a null. So width. So just I'm giving a, so 400, and height and just I'm giving a 100. Okay, so this is a statement. If I copy, paste it. Click on OK. Save. And publish. it is redirect to contact. So this time look on the back. So just I'm pressing the control F5, so that will reload the our latest JavaScript file. Click on service, click on accounts. So you can see here, right? So this is my web resource is opened. Okay. So on the form, okay. So my web resource is opened in another window. Okay. So that is a use of the open web resources.